plug-in city combined these elements, the principle of collectivity, interchangeable apartment units, incorporation of rapid transition, 1964 by Peter Cook. The Living City by Peter Cook, 1963. This is an aggregate of a metropolis. Palaces, places of government, control of monuments, symbols, or an established center, coming together of many minds. Plan and section of the Living City installation, 1963, showing its arrangement into gloops. Many associative ideas and emotions that can mean many things to many people. City Interchange Project, 1963, Warren Schock and Ron Heron, a traffic node clustered into architecture. Fulham Study, a modular form derived from elements of British townhouses. David Green created the Living Pod Project, 1966, a free-roving exploratory house called in the style of nomadic architecture. Archigram cutout puzzle, 1966, a cutout constructor kit. You could cut out and rearrange components by folding the pieces. All the units are capable of reorganization carried out by the owner. The units are prefabricated chunks of a building. The tower elevation are cantilevered cabins from a core with parking below. Lower Manhattan Expressway Project, Paul Rudolph, 1970, a mainstream megastructure with a conventional A-frame section of two sloping stacks of apartments over a giant transportation artery. The Monte Carlo Project, a lobby slipped beneath a public park. Seating escalators, stage, and booms could be wheeled away. Tomorrow City Hall, Louis Kahn, created in 1952. This building had a great influence on megastructure movement, one of the two prime sources for the diagonal frame. Archigram 1967 Megastructure Model Kit, a complete kit for a do-it-yourself megastructure. According to Raynor Banham, the Ponte Vecchio belongs to the megastructures canon with its temporary housing and shops on a multi-level bridge structure. Sant'Elia in 1914 drew the Milan Central Station project, which also had a direct influence on the megastructure movement. This is the George Washington Bridge, 1927 built. It is what Raynor Banham calls an accidental megastructure. This is a project by Le Corbusier, 1948, Roque a Rob. It's a regularized version of an Italian hill settlement. This image is a true beginning of megastructure ideas after World War II.